So good evening, everybody. I'm going to talk about important government schemes in India. In this presentation, I want to see about four schemes. First is about rural India. So what that is a scheme addressing to the rural India needs. Second is about the urban India. Third one is catering to the girl child, like primary girl child. Fourth one caters to the graduate people, those who are going to finish school and those who are going to the college. So basically urban, rural, then primary, girls, and then it caters to the needs of the urban people. Caters to the need of the graduates. So first one is Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act. So this is a scheme which came in addressing to the needs of the rural people. So this scheme, this says that, okay, government will give 100 days of wage employment to the people in rural areas. So they will get 100 days of wage employment. So it's basically unskilled labor. So they will be providing unskilled labor to the people in rural areas. So whoever applies will get 100 days of work. So what kind of work they will do is, they will build canals, they will lay roads. So they will be building ponds. So basically they will be engaging in those kind of infrastructure activities, you can see the picture as well. So you can planting trees, laying roads, etc. So this scheme addressing to the rural areas, so where basically 100 days of wage employment, unskilled wage employment will be given to the rural people. So this scheme says that if you apply for the work for the 100 days, it has to be provided within 15 days. It has to be provided within 15 days. So it is one of the ongoing schemes. There are many criticisms for the scheme, regarding the functioning of the scheme. There are a lot of criticism to this scheme. But since it is one of the important schemes, because it was started long back, 1960, and it is still functioning. So we have to look through what should be the changes we need to look up in this scheme. So next. So second one is Jawaharlal Nehru National Urban Renewal Mission. This is basically addressing the needs of the urban people about urban transport, sanitation, then cleanliness programs in the urban areas, and schemes addressing to the slum people. So those are covered under this Jawaharlal Nehru National Urban Renewal Mission. They have changed the name as Amrut. So basically it's about urban transport, slum development, sanitation, and providing housing facilities in the urban areas, etc. So this is covering the urban areas. So next is, this is very, very important, Suganya Samriddhi Yojana account. So this basically, this account, this year onwards, we are going to start this scheme in the school. This is basically a savings scheme, start with, we can do it in the post office. So those girl child who are below 10 years of age, you can start this account, Suganya Samriddhi account. So it will go, you need to invest 1000 rupees as a starting. You need to invest 1000 rupees, and every year you need to pay 1000 rupees. When you are starting the account, the girl child should be less than 10 years. So you can, so the rate of interest is 8.1. So the rate of interest is 8.1, and yes, you can withdraw the money at the 18 years of age. When the girl child turns 18 years of age, you can withdraw 50% of the money if it is for education purpose, and you can withdraw the full amount if the girl child is getting married at the age of 18. So you can withdraw the full amount. So you please read in full about the Suganya Samriddhi account. So this is basically if your kid is in 3rd or 4th or 5th standard, so basically they will be under 10. So you can take this scheme. So we are starting in our school. So we are going to have a PTA meeting in next week or next month, and we are going to call the parents and we are going to talk about the Suganya Samriddhi account, how they can open. So we are going to start for some 6 kids, and they are going to continue Suganya Samriddhi Yojana account. So this is basically another Beti Bacho Beti Padho scheme. So it falls under that. So you please go through in full. So next is first graduate in the family. This is basically a scheme of the Tamil Nadu government, where if your father and mother both are not a graduate, and if you are finishing school, if you are finishing 12th standard, if you are going to join college, or if you are finishing 10th and joining polytechnic college, you can avail the first graduate facility. So you do talk to your kids if your kid is in secondary, 8th, 9th or 10th. tell them, please, like, make them aware that there's something called first graduate. They can avail the scheme if their father and mother is not a graduate. So they can avail the scheme such that they get a lot of concessions in the fees and etc. So please tell them about first graduation so they can get the forms from Tahsildar office. And even when they're applying to counseling or medical counseling, so by default, the government is giving the forms nowadays. But still, they can apply like from the Tahsildar or village administrative offices, they can get the form and they can avail the facility. So basically, I talked about four, like first rural area, second like urban, third one I talked about Subhanya Samruddhi, fourth is about the first graduation. So this is basically the two magazines of the government. So this is basically the official magazines of the government. One is Yojana, next one is Kurukshetra. So Yojana basically talks about all the schemes. So this is a monthly magazine, so you can get it for 10 rupees. So these are all the schemes, whatever the government has given, schemes you can read in. Like anyway, you can refer to the websites of the particular respective ministries, but still you can use the, you can take, if you like to read in a book, even buy this magazine like just for 10 rupees, Yojana. Then Kurukshetra is for rural development. So Ministry of Rural Development releases Kurukshetra. So Yojana and Kurukshetra are the official magazines of the government. So you can read the government schemes from this. And there are like PIB website, PIB, you can refer to the authentic government like schemes, etc. Then you have Vikaspedia. Like by the government, it is run by the government. Thank you.